Ball game. Out of 5 here in the afternoon, the JBI Sports Network. Matthew Carrick joined by Chad Asseltine and the rest of our crew. The Punishers in black occupying the home bench. And the vicious Alpacas wearing red. They are on the visitor's bench. Punishers, this is their first game that we're seeing them. They get a bye through to the final. Vicious Alpacas had to go through the throwbacks to get here earlier this afternoon. However, Punishers going 3-1 in the round robin. Their only loss was to this Alpaca team. Alpacas start with the ball, keeping it outside. For a good shot. Down in deep, mid sider. Brings it down the far side. Finds over. Stops it right at center. Keith Gore. Turn over there by the Alpacas, looking to spring. For a breakaway. Kept at the line there. Mike Martin takes the shot off the backboards. Goes over to the halfboards. Keeping it in behind, Cal Kristoff. Gets the stop from the Alpacas, and we're going to have a quick tripping call here for the Punishers as the Alpaca player, Justin Dykstra, dropped right at center floor.
Yeah, it's an interesting path through the round robin for both of these. To a tough start in the tournament, they were down 0-2 in their record, and then they came back with two straight wins, got into the semifinal, upset the throwbacks, or beat the throwbacks, depending on how you want to see it, as the throwbacks had beat them yesterday.
Short-handed opportunity here, and then going over top of the goaltender. No harm at all, I think. Grant Patton just ran out of space. As he came in with a short-handed dick. None of the Alpaca teams near Kyle Kristoff took exception at all, so we continue. There's a shot from Kristoff, and as Pat said, on the point shot, that goes up over the cage and out of play.
John Wilson with the shot from the point there. That's what they're going to want to set up a lot. He has a heavy shot. The Punishers are going to look to feed it back to him.
John Wilson assisting on both scores. Punishers scored in a 3-2 victory for the Alpacas in the round robin. As they go down in the corner, maybe Alpacas. Punisher is able to keep it in here. Spin around, Grant Patton still providing the forecheck. It's going to be brought up by Jesse Davis. Far side for Mike Schramm. Schramm in the corner. Mike Davis now takes it off the half boards, and it comes up to the blue line where Grant Patton gets it down in the corner, giving chase Chris Wilkes. Wilkes and Dan Guthrie. They do battle in on the boards, and it's Mike Davis. Comes away with it out the blue line. Finds the zone. And right on the half boards when cage sets. Dug out by the Punishers and Erlog. Back down the floor, Adam Fortin, the first one. They keep the head by Mike Hartman. Not the Punishers, but the first one there is Jesse Cecil, and another leads out Sharon Schlapp from the Punishers. Right up on the near side, Jesse Davis. Mike Martin brings it in for the Punishers.
Working over to the far side now. As it's turned over, and Justin Davis brings it up over the line. Punishers with the turnover though. As Keith Gale, he tries a shot and goes off the cage. And down back is even strength on the floor. We're under 7 minutes to play. Pass in behind Susu. It's going to be Brian Zolga. Looking back to start the counterattack for the Punishers here. Looking in is Nick Sider. He's just trying to get it over for Mike Martin. And the Alpacas all over that. Alpacas trying to work out. Stolen by Punishers though. Mike Martin shot partial screen there for Christoph season and able to make the save.
Yeah, the Punishers roster this tournament is a bit different than some of the roster you would have seen a few of the other tournaments. They actually picked up a few extra Niagara North Stars who've begun playing on the team. So you'll see some of the green North Star shorts. Those are the guys, they play out of the Niagara Falls as a competitive travel team as well.
There is one of them, Keith Dale, working down into the corner. Stolen away though, Jesse Susie. Start the counterattack by the Alpacas. Trying to get around Ryan Chadwick. The backhand shot, a quick one there. Dropping down was Dennis Ray. And Ray makes his toughest stop of the contest so far.
Celebrating the birthday in the finals of the intermediate. Not too bad.
Jesse Susie up over center. Susie on the half boards. Ryan Chadwick will keep him to the outside. Susie goes up is Dan Guthrow. Point shot was taken away, so he just dumps it into the corner. No one home there. Punishers do pick up. It's lifted into the corner to allow the last couple Punishers to change up as we reach the halfway mark of the opening period. Off the boards. Maybe that's Justin Dykstrom out in front. A couple extra waxes raised down. And Ray hangs on and forced the face off to his left. Playing for the faceoff, comes up top. There's a shot that doesn't miss by a whole lot from up top. I believe Mike Proto taking that one. Dragged off the boards by Garrett Russell. He spins and fires. And that's over along the boards. Punishers, the first player is there in the corner. Looking for an outlet. They find it right in front of us in the form of Mark Sexsmith. Down low for John Rarden. Ball gets in and Christoph makes that save. 4 minutes to play now in the opening period. Walking out of the corner, still with it. What patience there from Mike Sexsmith, and great save from Christoph, matching him all the way to his right.
Christoph's keeping up his good play that allowed him in the semifinal earlier today. As moving the ball quite well, getting shots on, but very limited rebounds, very good ball control, seems to be doing the same thing here to start off the game.
Been some pretty good goaltending performances. Matt Cain for the Ringers in the Barn Division we saw as well. Shuttled in the semis and just one goal in that final.
He's a huge difference in the final in that Barn Division. A lot of glove saves, probably 4 or 5 memorable glove saves in that game.
Christoph watches this one sail wide into the corner. They continue to battle for it down in the corner. It comes all the way up top though. Keith Dale is there. Christoph trying to poke check just to keep it to the outside. Mike fired this rather. Looking to chip it off the boards and up to spring Mike Schramm. It's going to be up through the middle. On the stick of Brian Zolga in good position again for Christoph. Faceoff will come to the left. With Cal Christoph here with 3:27 to play. Game still awaiting the opening goal. Again, the last time these teams played in the round robin was an Alpaca victory, 3-2. Jesse Barbas running under this into the corner. Gets there first with a couple punishers spying in. That one chipped, I believe, off the stick of Mike Martin. Goes up over Dennis Wright. And the counterattack for the punishers, Keith Dale. They leave for Brian Zolga, his heavy outside shot, saved by Chris Dock. Keith Dale gets there and it's chipped into the corner. Jesse Barbas. Nobody on this side to keep it in, so it goes the length of the floor for Nicey.
It's interesting to see if you look at Jesse Barbas' shorts, he's actually wearing the Team Grease shorts that he wore. Well, I guess that was 2 weeks ago, or maybe 3 weeks ago at Worlds. That was over in the Czech Republic. The Barbas boys were playing, and so I played for Team Grease.
The icing, no change.
No change on ice. It looks like the punishers thought that there was some advantage gained by the Alpacas. Alpacas did not agree.
Cal Kristoff was trying to smother that right on the side of the net, couldn't do it, so play continues. Looks like it's going to be no harm there as Jesse Susie stood up at the red line and it. Punisher player stood him up and Jesse Susie fell, and we're going to have an interference penalty, I think, here on the Punisher.
Yeah, this one's always tough because I completely understand Nick Sauer's point of view there, that he's playing the ball, he stepped up, he got stick on the ball, but at the end of the day, it's a non-contact game. It's a non-contact game, and the refs are sensitive, especially the open floor, open ice collision.
Punishers work it through the center. And they do dump it down to kill first little bit. So for most of the rest of this period, as we're 2:01 remaining, the Alpacas will have a power play looking for the opening goal here. Dennis Ray has made some pretty good stops in this first period, as has Cal Kristoff. As the Punishers got lost in the feet of Grant Patton momentarily, kept in at the line though. Mike Little kept down low, out in front of the shot, and it's through the 5-hole, and that's Garrett Russell.
He just opened up that 5-hole just a little bit. I think Garrett's got some really good hands, and looked like he gave a little head fake. I thought he was going backhand, and I think that's what Dennis saw as well, thinking that he might get a little bangle there. Opened up the 5-hole, and Garrett just buried that. There wasn't much there, but just that little head fake seemed to open it up just a little bit. Garrett and Dennis are two guys who know each other very well. We played together, against each other, and many times are both well in boys.
Russell did have the opening goal for the Alpacas in the last minute of the first period when they played the Punishers in round robin. That time it made the score 1-1. This time 1-0 for Garrett Russell. Comes on the power play. Here's Russell with it again. Takes it over to the far hash marks. Stops in front of the Punishers bench. Spins and sends it back behind the net. In on the board, Mike Martin. He's got it and has to deal with Mike Croto, though. But back to Justin Dykstra. Out in front, Keith Dale. Stolen away by Dan Guthrow. Guthrow's going to send it up the boards for Brian Wright. And in the final 45 seconds here. That's Ryan Chadwick will take it. On the near side, they return it back. Punisher's making a change. Here's the outside shot from John Roerson. Over to the half boards, Chadwick come all the way down to the blue line, takes the shot. 30 seconds now as Jesse Barbas comes over. And Barbas up through the middle. Defense closing in, lifts it up off the face mask, I believe, of Dennis Ray, who went down to make that save. Nice job by the defense to push him over there, and good job by Barbas, even better job by Ray. Final 10 seconds here for the Punishers. Can they get one last shot away? Working off the boards. It is Rollison. Rollison just a good measure, gets it caught in the top of the cage.
That's a good block by Sheldon to finish that first period off. You never know when Ferguson gets a shot away. Everybody is on the floor. Even, well, some people who may be new to the BHI game or the outdoor ball hockey game, as you saw, we crossed the zone blue line. The back blue line is icing, and you may be saying, well, see, we're using a shot just putting that down there. No, his shot is that hard. It moves a lot. It's going to give the goalie trouble. If he has a forward who's running, you're going to play that rebound. It's a good play. Try and get it off the pads, force the goalie to kick it out. And you might have a nice little tap, and so it's definitely a play you'll see a lot in the outdoor ball hockey game.
Last weekend, the JumpStart Jammer in the youth division. This weekend, the adult division. I believe our next broadcast on JVI and BHI comes your way August the 8th. That tournament coming up. Yes, Chad?
It is. It is the weekend of chance for our youth Ontario Cup. So the winners and second place finishers from our youth divisions from our preliminary ball hockey tournaments, Youth Ontario Cup tournaments this year, will be meeting up for the culinary tournament prize.
Again, that comes your way the weekend of August 8th.
That will be at BHI Brantford.
And we will have those games for you. Please visit ballhockeyinternational.ca, jvisportsnetwork.com for more info on the tournament and for our broadcast schedule as that tournament approaches. Teams have switched sides here for this second period. Still just a one goal in that opener from Garrett Russell on the power play. Gives a 1-0 lead to the Vicious Alpacas. 2-1, nobody coming in, and Jesse Soucy gets the shot. Dennis Ray the save as he goes to the right pad. Wheeling around the side though, Chris Williams comes in and another save, this time from the glove.
That's a big kick save. Big kick save by Dennis as he tried to pull it back over to his forehand and tuck it in, and Dennis just kicked that out with some pretty good authority actually. It's like he knew it was coming.
Face off one by the Alpacas here. Now he makes the save with the blade of the stick. Sends it up over the cage, out of play. And I guess they're going to say that went straight out as the face off comes outside the blue line here.
Interesting. That one did get off of Dennis, the shot to Dennis' stick, but looks like the official really caught that.
Susie's shot goes in and is blocked, and the Punishers regain possession. Take it up the floor, Jesse Soucy, at thoughts of another breakaway.
I can speak from experience, he's fast.
Soucy trying to go up and over now the block of the defender, but Nick Sider catches up to that ball, and Soucy not sure about that modified hip check, I guess. And here comes Grant Patton. His shot works into the corner, giving chase Mark Sexsmith. Back up the middle, kept in by Sider. He lifts the shot just over the glove and slightly wide. Goes back into the corner, Sexsmith there again. This one's gonna be lifted up into the cage. Brian Zolga comes up again for Sider before rattling around the boards out in front of the Punisher zone from the face-off dot on the far side. Backing up was Patton. Comes Sider again. A lot of hard outside shots. So far, none of them able to find the mark. Comes over, Sider chops at it. That sends it skyward out of the reach of Susie. And the ball arrives on scene in front of the alpaca bench just at the wrong time as they're making a change.
Yeah. Seemed like there was a big mash of people there, mash of bodies. Ball hit the player as he was still on the floor. Saw the close official to us did signal too many men, but it looks like they're going to talk about it as the official who's closer to the actual change may have seen something a little different.
Well, and with that many bodies too, it is hard to pick out who's coming off, who's going on, who's staying on.
It is. It's such a, it's a bang-bang call. You really have to, try and count. You have to make sure that it doesn't just look bad, but it actually, there are too many. And you have to call immediately. Yeah.
But if it hits a guy when his replacement is on the floor or before his replacement's gone off, then that's...
In this case, it looked like the player who's going off is who he hit while his replacement was already on the floor. So we'll see what punishers do with the setup of the power play here. They have a lot of guys who can move that ball around. They like to set up a man high in the slot and get that one timer. They try and create a two-on-one on the defender, and that's when they take their chances once they feel that they've isolated the defender.
Well, they've got three big defenders back, Brian Wright and Dan Guthrow and Mike Croto. And it looks like Wright is the guy that's going to go up for the Alpacas. Pop back a little bit here. There was Burleson. Doesn't take the shot. Works it into the corner. Comes back up top. Again, they don't look for the shot, as it does come from the top of the face-off circle. And it rolls away from Brian Zolga. Comes up from Zolga. Takes the way outside shot. Comes back up to the point. Spinning through that one. And the rebound as they come down. Someone swiped at the initial shot. Not sure if it was Mike Croto or Cal Kristoff, but the Alpacas weren't able to clear and resulted in a second opportunity.
I'm not sure if it was deliberately done, if Zolga was trying to put that on net, but his hard dump into the far side corner is great on the power play. He knew he was winger to get in there, pick up the loose ball, and that set up that whole play, the whole offensive zone. Time was all created from that hard dump into the far side corner.
Two goals in this game now, both of them coming on the power play, were tied one apiece. And their round robin game was a tight matchup as well, 3-2.
Coming in, 40, coming in right here.
The winner coming with minute 58 left on the clock. Here's a shot from the Punishers that goes off the pipe. Brian Wrighton got through the defense and couldn't settle it down, and neither could Garrett Russell as he came down the far side trailing. Punishers touch up. Negate the offside call. Brian Zolga, this one in behind Kristoff, bounced off his back foot, but it just rolled across the goal line after going off the top of the cage. Here comes Zolga again. He takes a shot from the half marks. Comes back up to the point. They can't get it around Russell. There's Ryan Chadwick on that shot. Chadwick comes into forecheck now as they switch up. Adam Fortin. He looks for Croto. Fortin again in the corner, has a quick look. Croto again as the Alpacas go for a line change.
Middle.
Croto, bound to go up the middle. They do, and Ray is right in on him, made the save. As does Kristoff. Both goaltenders have holding on for face-offs, but they both keep the play alive, and we're approaching the halfway mark of this period and this match. Far side, they come back, and it won't settle down again for Keith Dale. So he can let one go. Ryan Chadwick has a chase into the corner. Mike Croto there, as is Mike Barbas. Barbas has Mike Schramm with him. Now Mike Barbas gets it back.
Hey,
Mike and Jesse Barvis looking for the cycle, but they lose it to Greg Patton, who works in. Five hole was open, closes quickly on Kristoff, and another great save by Cal Kristoff.
From my angle here, I thought that was, I don't know how he stopped that. He must have just got a toe, because I think that went pretty far back into the pads.
Five hole definitely was open. And it looked like a little late getting down in the butterfly too, but.
Yeah, watch out. Looks like Mike Martin's heating up for the Punishers. Scored the goal, hit the post right after the shot, and then South Keith there with a nice little play. So let's see if he starts getting hot. He can see the floor well.
Play goes into the corner. Worked out Chris Wilkes. And heads up on the Punisher bench as that one goes into the backboard behind them. 4:18 now in the second period.
Both teams really seem to be feeling each other out. The neither team also wants to take too big of a chance because they're both loaded with offense. So that's the gamble, especially at this this caliber of ball hockey. You don't want to make that mistake because it can really be in the back of your net quickly.
Comes Jesse Soucy into the corner. John Rorison in on him, and again Soucy loses the stick, this time the sunglasses as well. And the Alpacas are offside. Goes into the corner, Chris Williams. Alpacas trying to bring it out. They work back for Dable. Stolen by the Punishers, though. Out in front, stick was tied up from Mark Sesmith. So Kristoff with a couple Punishers right on the doorstep.
He did a good job. He made that look really easy finding that loose ball. It definitely was had some spin. It was moving and very confidently just scooped it up.
Credit Justin Dable as well. He got a nice chip to keep that one deep away from the Punishers, and then when it got down deep, tied up the stick of Mark Sesmith. Spinning here is Nick Sider. From the point out in front, Brian Zolga, Cal Kristoff didn't see that centering pass come out, and it just bounces off the stick of Zolga.
I don't think that's how you draw those up, but it works. Keep the up to just spin and put it in front. He knew Zolga was there. He's a big body presence in front of that net, and Zolga had the hand-eye coordination just to bat that in.
We talked about the guys from Niagara, three of them of the five on this line now.
It's actually four. So I guess just wearing those very big shirts, but he's in fact an original North Star.
See the green gloves now. But those four guys, they've got that chemistry from playing together.
They do, they grew up together in Niagara Falls playing the outdoor rink there.
And another goal from the Punishers. You called it right off the top. As we watched the Alpacas looking for the answer, and just unable to lift that up was Justin Dykstra. With the Punishers, two goals now, both of them not clear direct in from the outside point shot, but started with that point shot, getting it in deep.
They've been avoiding the back shot, starting it deep, and letting their guys go get that ball. They're confident that their forwards are going to win ball battles.
From outside, Guthrie. Ray had to get the glove on it and just went high. Guthrie's going to try a second attempt. As Guthrie follows that shot in onto the crease, and Dennis Ray just going to hang on with 2:44 left to play.
Dennis seems to really calm down. In the first period, but the first few minutes, I wondered if it was the hot flow, but he has sliders on the inside of his pads. I noticed he was probably sliding a little more than he wanted to on a couple of those shots. He might even get himself a little too far out on his angle. But he seems to have calmed it down right now, and he's playing nice and square and strong. When he challenges, he's a big goalie. It's very difficult to beat him.
Quick point shot there from Mike Croteau, and he talked about just a calm presence to it. Kicks out that left pad and pops right up. Dennis Ray on that save right there. They work into the corner. Jesse Barbas coming away with it. Looked like he was going to leave from Mike Schramm, who likes to go up top. Justin Dable. And Mike Barbas almost got stick on that to tip it in front of Ray, but goes into the corner. Zolga there. Zolga up for Keith Dill. Batted out of midair. A bit of a look to the official from Zolga. That play continues as Zolga chases that to the far side.
Might have been a high stick for a shorter guy, but Zolga's height helped him out there.
Down low, here's Keith. And the trailer just shoots it wide. Wide and high up into the cage as Dable has to do some stick handling here to Wade Camp from Darian Gilbert. And there's the shot. Croto getting into shooting lane nicely. This one goes wide. Mike Croto chases it into the corner again. He's going to lift it up down in the corner. And Jesse Soucy limping off here. He takes his spot on the visitor bench. Chris Wilkes. Again, there's a cutter to the net. Grant Patton said these teams starting to feel each other out. I think Punishers have felt, and they're picking their spots now.
You know, I must have seen the long change at the end of the second period come into play, because these I believe Dable's been out on the floor for a good 2 minutes, maybe even more, and you see he's really feeling it. Tired as a defenseman to get that change at the end of this period. See if the Punishers can isolate him.
Coming through, there's another outside shot from Wilkes. Off the cage, and the play down low. They're in the board battle again behind the net. He comes out in front of Kristoff. And Sexsmith makes it 3-0.
You can see them laboring off those guys. It was a long shift for them getting stuck in their defensive zone. That long change, you're looking at the bench and it just seems so far away.
In our ruck final, the Broad Street Blazers, they won their way in via forfeit, and the Sarnia Beavers had to play their way in. Again here today, the Punishers get a bye into the final, whereas the Alpacas had to play their way in. And this heat, playing that extra game or getting that extra rest, has already come into play here this afternoon. Maybe we're seeing it again. Punishers able to keep it on the correct side of the red line for Roarson. As they get it down deep, they change up. Final 15 seconds here of the second period. It's brought in by Grant Patton, three on now two. And nice hustle back by Garrett Russell to even up the numbers. Comes to the near side, Brian Wright, in 5 seconds to take the shot. He does, but it's into the legs of John Roarson. And on the near side, they stall it. And time expires, but a big period for the Punishers.
It's an interesting way that shows there between Brian Wright and John Morrison. They're two teammates, a team that used to play together, called the Terriers, who traveled all across the province playing as a competitive team. Many of the Punishers actually had played on the Terriers as well, but they had an exchange of current fans, but for many years, teammates, and oftentimes defensive partners too. The temperature today is about the same as it was yesterday, but yesterday had such a great breeze here that everyone was okay with it. It was nice and cool, and today the wind has sort of died down.
Mark Sexsmith with the goal there. He got the second Punishers goal in that round robin loss or win for the Alpacas. Garrett Russell, Chris Williams, and Brian Wrighton were the goal scorers in that game for the Alpacas. So far, the power play goal from Garrett Russell. Power play one from Mike Martin, Brian Zolga, and Mark Sexsmith. Give us three for the Punishers. 3-1 score after two periods. They'll switch sides one final time here. Kyle Kristoff returns the net to our right. There's that shot. Goes up over the boards. And Dennis Ray down to our left as we, in the final period here of the JumpStart Jammer in the adult division and final period of our coverage this afternoon on JBI Sports Network. face off to the left of Cal Kristoff, Matthew Carrick, and Chad Asseltine. In for this final. Kristoff tried to glove that out of midair, juggled it slightly before hanging on, and they'll do the face-off again, 17 seconds gone.
The rare backhand catch in hockey. Be interesting to see how the Alpacas start this period. This is going to be a big first few minutes. They definitely don't want to give up another, and to get some pressure and some momentum would be huge for them now.
Mike Barbas trying to cut through the middle. It was stolen away by the Punishers. Kristoff not sure where that was, so 31 seconds gone a couple times now. Not sure where the ball was for Kristoff. After a solid period and maybe period and three quarters, I guess.
Those goaltenders go through a lot of water right here in a day like this, and I'm sure they're shedding a few pounds with water right being gone, so to the end of the game will take its toll on those guys wearing the equipment.
Is Ray wearing the white jersey as opposed to the black here this afternoon of the Punishers. Probably a smart choice for the goaltender. As Wrighton brings it up for the Alpacas, drops it deep.
I'm going to ask him if he actually thought that through. Not used to it. That is a good point.
Comes Brian Zolga. Rips one from outside, goes just wide down into the corner. Brian Wrighton, first man there. He gives for Garrett Russell. They start up to play as everyone holds the line and is chipped away by the Punishers. Jesse Soucy, Dean Chase, and Dennis Rowe all over that to poke it into the corner. Punishers. Not willing to force the issue here as they just keep it deep. Soucy will go into forecheck, as will Justin Dykstra, and now they do bring it up in the last trailer there. Chris Wilkes gets into the corner. He was looking to go straight up the middle as they scored a couple.
Get back,
so far on that play. Garrett Russell again. Ryan Wrighton, he tries to go through the middle. Justin Dykstra takes it to the side though. And now Dykstra's going to lose it. Grant Patton gets it back for Ryan Chadwick. Chadwick near side, Chris Wilkes. And through the middle, Sexsmith has that chipped away. Another good back check there, this time Mike Barbas.
The defensive game is really kind of, it's a big differentiator between the levels of hockey out there is in ball hockey. You'll see great back checking in the intermediate division. The guys don't want to give any time. They close gaps very well. That's really a big separator between the levels, because the skill is there in the other levels, but maybe some of the knowledge and the defensive knowledge isn't.
Well, over the last 7 days, there's a shot, the mesh rippled, but I guess that was just the stick, and it's not Jesse Barbas. May have had one, it goes to the far side. Grant Patton, the out of those six divisions, that includes the youth Pee Wee Bantam midget we saw last week. The amount of chatter that happens on the floor as the levels get higher, too.
We really go through the stick pretty dramatically. From an owner standpoint, but talking to one another from a strategy standpoint, that takes over. Everyone's talking to each other, everyone's communicating. Typically the vocal stuff in some of the other divisions isn't so productive.
Face off just outside the zone here, Punishers. Still up 3-1, just inside of 7 minutes to play here in the third period. As walking through with Brian Zolga, elected to take the shot and went chest high, coming near side, along the near boards. Rich Plant had thoughts of taking it to the net, and as he tried to backhand it out, the paddle of Ray was there. Jethro and his men came off the boards together. Punishers are going to end up with the ball. Trying to poke check of his own was Kristoff and got around, but the backhand unable to connect there. John Rodney, he chips it up for Keith Dale and it's loose in front of Kristoff again. A good quality shot and ends up in the back of the net.
Mike Martin just ran a couple of ball battles there. We had a defender all over him. He was able to find, get the first shot off on his rebound, and then the second.
McCain, after Brian Zolgas, streaked through the middle and took an outside shot. Four goals now, all of them started from way out there for the Punishers and winning the board battle down low. So make it 4-1 now, closing in on second half of the third period. Face-off tied in a mess of sticks and legs as Plant works in the field on the boards. Mike Crotto's got to give chase here. Going to play it back in behind his own net. That looked like it took a turn on the floor. And that's a bad hop for Brian Redden as it comes in and make it 5-1 for the Punishers.
That was unfortunate. Just a bad bounce off the boards. Nothing either. Nothing any of the Alpacas can do on that.
And you can see that from the Punishers. No big, huge celebration on that goal. If it's a pretty play, I think you may see.
They know they got a bit of a gift on that one.
Face-off one and wraps down. Dennis Ray steers it to the side. Punishers trying to blow out. Jesse Susie gets the stick on that. Goes up the four boards in front of the Punisher bench. They'll come across the floor. Up the middle, pass Nick Satter. Brian Layton from the corner goes up for Crotto. Crotto from outside, I remember the glove, it was Dennis Rowe, ended up batting it all the way ahead. Up there for Chris Wilkes. He lets one fly, just misses to the stick side. Off the near boards, Jesse Susie. First man there, Darian Gilbert. And something happened there between Susie and Gilbert. As they shove with couple grins. Don't think there was an initial call until we got up and started shoving. Both benches are kind of talking about that, but
it looked odd. It looked like the foul actually might have been as he got tangled up in Rory's stick. And I think he thought that it was the offensive player, Susie. It seemed to just be kind of a mash of sticks there, and the big goalkeeper stick might have done the most damage. Actually, I believe that might be a birthday gift to sound taping it up earlier. From the parents, he said.
Working pretty good so far. Seems to be got him to a 5-1 lead here, 5-0-6 to play now. And there are guys on this Alpaca squad who can finish, but one of the hardest workers we've seen so far on the day has been Jesse Susie, one of the fastest anyways, and he's going to sit for the next little while.
His game is definitely based around his speed.
Rocking off the wall, the shot. Kristoff thought he had it, but it bounced wide. Off the stick of Mike Martin looking for the hat trick here. Goes for Jesse Bogus. Bogus over center. Flies back off the half boards. Goes for Mike Schramm. Schramm lets one rip. That's into the back of Keith Dale. Mike Bogus behind his own net bar. And Keith falls.
He comes outside the red line. Holding there, Chris Williams. Now gets it over for Schramm. Schramm tries to go through the middle. Keith Dale intercepts. He'll bring it out and to the blue line, kicks back. Nice little play there by Chris Williams. Get it on the stick of Dingo. Stolen away by Brian Zerga. Zerga back up top off the shaft of the stick of Mike Schramm. As it drops down, Garrett Russell. Throw the middle with down for Justin Dykstra. He gives chase. Far wing. As Punishers pass around, closing in final 3 minutes now. Go through the middle. Garrett Russell. He's got Grant Patton getting called for a hook here on the trail. As Garrett Russell tried to flip it around, he was behind on a step and looks like he's called for the hook.
You hear all the time is ref standing right there, it's his call. That's actually not his call. The control official is the one who's looking at that play, because the near official, it's actually hard to see the stuff that's right at you. Your job is more so to call the goal and anything down low across the floor. The high official is actually looking from the slot to if it's on the boards to help his partner on any of those situations, because his partner has to make sure he's safe in that mix of bodies. So, but oftentimes when guys aren't quite sure what the procedures are, you hear them make the assumption.
5-on-4, good opportunity for the Alpacas. Inside of 3 minutes, they're staring down a four-goal hill. Mike Schramm all the way back. They go for Credo, back for Schramm again. Schramm will lift it up and hustles into the corner. Play like that is really where they miss Jesse Soucy, and they will on this power play with extra room. And he's got to wait for another whistle now to be released on the offsetting line.
Three forwards that they have out there are also considered speed demons. So, but Soucy's given them a lot in this weekend.
Shot off the glove coming off the stick of Mike Schramm. Played in behind the net. Over for, pardon me, that was Mike Schramm. This is Jesse Barbas. Back to play for Crotto. Barbas back again. Under 2 minutes to go now. There's Dan Guthrow. Outside, they got one. In all alone. And Justin Dykstra, and I think that's whistled offside until they come outside the zone.
I do believe Guthrow had zone there, so I think that one might have been missed. I believe that was a good zone, but it happens. I think if it wasn't a 5-1 game, you might hear a little more argument from the officials out back at this point, but. Under 2 minutes on the clock in the third period, 5-1 lead for Punishers. Just some minor complaints.
Number four, Saf here, coming to the right of Dennis Ray, clock down in final 90 seconds here. Quick up to the play, good positioning that way again. Rich Plant on the ball. Adam Ferdin. On the point, another save. Susie back on the floor, the wraparound there. And roll right over that post. As the penalty has expired, Punishers. With five on the floor. Here's Rich Plant. Up top for Fortin. Back for Plant. They have Susie in front, but stick of the defender was right there. Turned over. Punishers come out. Half to half birds. It's flipped. Then we go down the floor. 30 seconds. And I think the Alpacas, you can hear them maybe waving the white flag here. They recognize four goals with 20 seconds, maybe a little too much. John Rodney. Steals that away, and the bunches will come out for handshakes.
And that's the game.
As the final 10 seconds continue to wind down here, but it'll be a 5-1 score in favor of the Punishers to take the final of the intermediate division. Final thoughts on the tournament or this game, Chad?
Well, the Punishers came out really strong, game one, and really kind of rode that through. So for a lot of the players, a lot of the spectators around, they were a little surprised by the Alpacas win earlier today, because there was a lot of talk around the rink that they felt that the Punishers had the strongest roster. And it wasn't so much just that they had the strongest roster, but the roster that also played like a team more so than some of the others, because there were a lot of other strong rosters, but they may not have been guys who played together that as often as the guys on the Punishers have. So I would have to say that that sort of the team that came in to this tournament as the front runner finished off with the title.
And that is the Punishers. Congratulations to them and the other two finalists in both the Bell and the Rec division. You can see all the games on the GVI Sports Network via archive, and visit bellhockeyinternational.ca for the rest of the tournaments. Our director today has been Ryan Harkins, producer and camera operator Gary Marison. That's our JVI crew. On behalf of them and my partner, Chad Asseltine, I'm Matthew Kirk. Please remember to join us on August 8th. But until then, we'll talk to you next time.